I'm really delighted that you're all able to join us today. And let's think for just a moment that at this moment, at this very moment, there's somebody crossing the border. Right now, there's somebody crossing the border that doesn't know if they're going north, that doesn't know if that person up ahead is gonna rob them or kidnap them, that doesn't know if they have really crossed the border or if they're still in their own country, that doesn't know if they're gonna make it. And right now, there's a mother and a father waiting for their son or their daughter and wondering what happened. Did they make it? Are they buried in that Hopeville Cemetery that we go every month where there's 700 unidentified people buried? Did they get arrested? Did they remarry? There's thousands of people. We need to have humane immigration reform because every day that passes, two people die. Two people die. 10,000 human beings have died. You can see some of the articles on there. You see some of the crosses. You see some of the work of the Border Angel Volunteers and other like-minded organizations. I'm going to tell you about Marco Antonio Villaseñor. He was a five-year-old little boy. And when he crossed for the same reason most of our parents came here, for economic opportunity. And as he crossed, he became very thirsty. And he asked his father for some water. And his father wouldn't give him any water. So he asked the next man for some water, and the next man, and the next man. He asked 18 men for water. And why didn't these men give the little boy water? Not even the father. It was because they were all dead. They were all dead, and Marco Antonio Villaseñor also died. 19 human beings that perished in Victoria, Texas in the spring of 2003. But it's not only little boys and men, it's also women, like Lucrecia Dominguez, who crossed for the really only other reason people cross. They cross for economic opportunity, that's two-thirds, or the other third for family reunification. She crossed and contracted a smuggler. The smuggler said, okay, I'll take you, but don't bring those two little kids with you, Jesus, her 15-year-old son, or Nora, the 7-year-old girl. Why not? Because they're gonna slow us down. They're gonna slow us down, and what's gonna happen is the Border Patrol might catch us. So she paid what was paid back then, $1,500 per person. Now it's $5,000, $6,000. And this is from the northern border across, not the whole journey. So she pays, and the next day she shows up, and the smuggler says, okay, I'll cross you. And as they're crossing, sure enough, the children did slow the group down. So the smuggler did not return the money, and they left without Lucrecia and her two children. And Lucrecia Dominguez literally died in the arms of Jesus, her 15-year-old son, Jesus. This is happening every day. So sign those letters for immigration reform. Sign them and leave them on the table. So Mahatma Gandhi's grandson comes to the University of San Diego to speak. And he shares a story about a man walking along the beach with his son. And as he's walking along the beach with his son is picking up these starfish and he's throwing them into the ocean. So the father says to the son, what are you doing? And he goes, well, I'm throwing these starfish into the ocean. And he says, yeah, I can see that, but why are you doing it? And he says, father, the sun is so hot and the tide has gone in, these starfish are dying. And the father says, son, there's thousands of starfish. What you do doesn't make any difference. So the little boy picks up a starfish and he shows it to his father. And he says, it'll make a difference to this one. The power of one. The power of one. That starfish could be a person. Had that starfish been there for Luis Ramirez, maybe he wouldn't have been beat to death in Shenandoah, Pennsylvania. Had that starfish been there for Marcelo Lucero in Long Island, New York, maybe he wouldn't have been kicked to death, the Ecuadorian young man that was killed a few years ago. Had that starfish been there to that little Irish girl that stopped going to school one day because they were saying, you Irish this and you Irish that, so one day she didn't show up. So her favorite teacher went to go see what happened to her. 15-year-old Phoebe Prince had hung herself in her bedroom. We gotta stop the bullying and stop the hate because we do gotta stand on the side of love. We do have to do the right thing. And that's why people like Josefina Lopez and Ruben Navarrete and Gil Cedillo and all of you that are here tonight are doing the right thing, and we really appreciate everything that you all do. But I want to ask the two co-chairs of this evening event to come up and join me for a second, because I do want to recognize the wonderful work that Richard Griswold del Castillo and Pam Calori did. So Pam and Richard, if you could please come up here. And we all know Dr. Ricardo Griswold del Castillo and the wonderful work that he all does. And Ricardo, you have influenced so many people. And with your books and your writings and your teachings, and you're a great friend, and I'm glad that you're part of the Border Angels family, that you're the co-chair for this event today. And these beautiful crosses that were made by Pam Calore. Pam, why don't you present it to him? It's a beautiful cross that Pam did, and it has pictures of Chicano Park. And as we all know, Dr. Griswold wrote a book about Chicano Park in his, with his many books. So Dr. Griswold, thank you very much for your work and your friendship. And also we have an something for Pam Calore. Pam, who's a wonderful friend and artist and the co-chair of this event, she has worked tirelessly for this event, like no one else. And the reason that we were able to be successful today was because of all the volunteers that you see here, the people that serve the food from the University of San Diego, the Dream students that joined us today, and their moms, our families, all the other volunteers, all the Border Angel volunteers. And we really appreciate all the work of all of you. And Pam, this beautiful son, because you are a light to the Border Angel family. We love the fact that you're our executive director, I guess, the coordinator for our efforts. So thank you very much, Pam. Thank you very much, all of you.